number 16. And it was told King David, saying, the Lord has blessed the house of Obed-Edom, and all that pertained unto him because of the ark of God. So David went forth and brought the ark of God from the house of Obed-Edom into the city of David with gladness. And it was so that when he had bare the ark of the Lord, had gone six places, he sacrificed oxen and fatling. And David danced before the Lord with all his might, and David was girded with linen of ephod. So David, all the house of Israel, brought up the ark of the Lord with shouting, and with the sound of the trumpet. 16, and as the ark of the Lord came into the city of David, Michal, Saul's daughter, looked through the window and saw David leaping and dancing before the Lord, and she despised him in her heart. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. We want to talk, amen, from the subject, if I can dance with my father again. If I can dance with my father again. We all know the singer of that song, Brother Luther, amen. A great singer. I remember him, amen, in his 20s when he was singing, amen, with a group called Change, amen. And how he came to be, amen, and how he wrote and co-wrote and arranged so many songs. On yesterday, as I was out, as I said, amen, cleaning the parking lot, amen, and Brother McDaniel was in here cleaning the sanctuary, amen, I asked the Lord, amen, to give me, amen, a sermon. And as, amen, I was cutting the grass the old-fashioned way, amen, I didn't use, amen, the weed whacker, I used, amen, the old-fashioned double blade. You know what I'm talking about? I see somebody know what I'm talking about. Amen. I wanted to try to get, amen, a little work and a little labor in. The sun was hot, and amen, but I just needed to do that for me because the thing that I told you about, amen, with the little girl, I just had to work some things off. You know how sometimes, amen, God can, amen, ease your pain and ease your mind when you're doing a little bit of work. Can I get a witness? Amen. That's how we know, amen, that mama, when she used to work and shine the floors and vacuum, or well, we didn't have a vacuum in the projects, amen, hands and knees, and come on, somebody, amen. We couldn't afford carpet. We had that floor, amen. But, you know, mama, grandmother would sing a song, amen. And so while I was out there, like I was in the field swinging the blade and cutting the grass, amen, the Lord gave me, amen, something about fathers. And I said, amen, I thought about my dad, and I said, I wish, amen, that I could dance with my father again. And the premise of, amen, this story, the premise, amen, of this title, amen, is that the devil does not want men, amen, to show their emotions out in public. Can I get a witness here? They want men to be stoic. They want men, amen, to think about their masculinity. They want men to think, amen, that if they show emotion, that it may show weakness. But I want you to know, my brothers, sometimes you're going to have to cry. Sometimes you're going to have to shed a tear. Sometimes you're going to have to go before the Lord, and Lord, amen, is going to have to humble you. Can I get a witness here? And then you'll find out, amen, that sometimes, amen, that there'll be, amen, folk in your life that will despise you as men for giving God your heart, amen, for giving God all that you can give. There will be folk that will try to deter you from serving your God. But I stop by to let you know that I wish I had an opportunity to dance with my father again. The scripture talks about, amen, David bringing the Ark of the Covenant into the house of Obed-Edom. Obed-Edom, amen, in our time frame will be something what we call a trustee or a deacon, because he was responsible for the Ark of the Covenant. You understand, the Ark of the Covenant, amen, was the house of where the Ten Commandments, were placed in. Can I teach somebody this morning that after Moses had been, amen, 40 days on top of Mount Sinai, he came down and he saw the men had lost their minds. Sometimes, my sisters, men, we do lose our mind. Y'all better help me out, brothers. Sometimes we get besides ourselves, and sometimes God has got to bring us down to our knees and get our attention, and he comes down from the mountaintop and he sees that the men who are in charge of the people of Israel have lost their mind, and God said, I'm going to get them, brothers. I'm going to take them down. And so Moses broke the Ten Commandments and he placed them in what is called the Ark of the Covenant. If you know, and if you ever seen Raiders of the Lost Ark, you know what I'm talking about. If you don't have it, see Sister Henry. I think she got that in her repertoire. Understand. Understanding the premise is that whenever men put God before them, amen, men were victorious. I stop by to let the men in this ministry, amen, until we put God before us. Come on, somebody. Until we bend down and acknowledge that God is the head of our lives. Until we come to the fruition, amen, and understanding that if we want the ministry to go, if we want God to bless our hands and bless our feet and bless, amen, our seed offering, amen, we've got to walk before God. Oh, I wish I could dance with my Father again. It tells us in the story, amen, that David, amen, brought the Ark of the Covenant to Obed-Edom. And as long as the Ark of the Covenant was in Obed-Edom's house, his house was blessed. His money got fat. His cattle grew. What I'm trying to tell us, brothers, amen, if you want your pocket to get fat, you got to get God in your life. If I can dance with my Father again. It goes on to say, amen, that after they had built the temple, amen, David, amen, put on an ephod, amen. An ephod is kind of a big diaper. Somebody say, teach me, Pastor. He had on an ephod. Ephod, amen, is, if I can bring it down a little bit lower, an ephod is a pamper. Anybody get my drift now? You know what I'm talking about? Amen. This ephod that David wore, amen, was a wrapping around himself made of Egyptian cotton, made of good fiber, amen. And David said, amen, that the Lord has kept me. The Lord has been with me. I have fought many battles, and God has been there with me when they took my wife and my children. And I asked God, can I go get my stuff back? David said to the Lord, shall I pursue? Shall I overcome? And God responded to the man of valor. He said, David, go get your stuff back. And if you put me before you, not only will you get your stuff back, you're going to get his stuff back. Brothers, I stopped by to tell you, I'm going to get my stuff and your stuff. So they're in the Ark of the Safety, Ark of the Covenant. Amen. And God, amen, said to David, he said, David, I want you to take the Ark of the Covenant out of Obed-Edom's house, and I want you to put it inside of the temple that you built. And David said, Lord, if you want me to do that, if you want me to be the man that you want me to be, I'm not afraid to show the world that I belong to the Lord Jesus Christ. And he said, I am so happy. And David began to dance with his Father. I've never learned how to do the cha-cha. I've never learned how to do the electric slide. All I know how to do is the feeling dog. Come on, somebody. All I know how to do is the twist. Amen. But when God came into my life, I got a new dance I can do. I got a new father that I can dance with. The Lord has taken my biological father, my physical father from me in 1990. Amen. But God has always been right there. I'm not ashamed to tell the world that I can dance before my Father with a great dance. The Bible says that David got so happy because he knew that it was God that gave him the victory. I stopped by to tell the men of New Lawn Baptist Church that if we want the victory, we cannot be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We got to be, help me, Holy Ghost. We got to be able to stand before the people of this church and tell God that I'll dance before you. I'll do whatever it is that it takes to bring me back to relationship with him. But I want to let you know today that even though you dance with your father, there'll be somebody standing on the sideline saying why he's dancing like this. But let me tell you something, honey. You don't know what the Lord has done for me. You were not there how God brought me out of a horrible place. You were not there when God put my feet on a rock to stand. You were not there when God lifted me up out of my mess and turned my life around. You were not there. It was God that got me up this morning. It was God. I'm going to dance. I said I'm going to dance with my Father again. That's why I'm not afraid to give God the shout. I'm not afraid. And so David said, you know what? It was God that gave up the victory over the Amorites, over the Hittites, over the Jebusites. It was God when Saul tried to kill me. It was God because God has been so good. God has been a father. When my father left me at the age of 16, I said, where are you going, Daddy? Daddy said, I got to leave. But when my father walked out, God walked in. And God has been my father down through the years. And I got to say, thank you. Thank you. I need a dance partner. I'm going to dance with my father again one of these days. And it won't be long. Me and Johnny Marion Sr., we going to dance again. But we going to dance before our Maker. We going to dance before our King. And so David said, God has made me happy. And I'm going to dance. And David, I said, David, dance before the Lord. And the Bible said that his temper got wet, his diaper got wet. And the Bible said that David jumped out of his clothes. He was so happy for what God had done. My brothers, I said, my brothers, you got to be willing to dance for the Lord. You got to be willing to say, Father, oh Father, I stretch my hand to thee. So the Bible says that David danced before the Lord. He danced so much, he felt it's right, that his clothes came off. He kept on dancing. I want you to know you got health issues. Keep on dancing. You're looking for a job. Keep on dancing. God will make a way. 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 Keep on dancing. God's gonna make a way. Keep on dancing. The Bible says, the Bible says, the Bible says that David, I said David got up, took off his clothes. David got up and said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel. And he began to dance before the Lord. And then watch this. There's always somebody, always somebody that's going against you. And the Bible says that Saul's daughter, who is now his wife, looked from the window, say, neighbor, somebody always looking, say, neighbor, somebody always in your business. She said, look at David dancing like that. Look at David, my husband. Look at David.